and smoking weed, avoiding police right up the street. Way back in the day before I had all of this paper. All right, people, this is part two. We got 8 minutes left. This is part two. So you have to let these people, you know, like Chris said, you gotta, it was just gonna be a moment, matter in time before he got himself in some real shit. Let's go to Sierra, caught texting from out of Texas. She wanted to say, it's really fucked up how they doing these cops. I have a brother who's a police officer, and if any one of these guys would ever try to spit or humiliate my brother, it would be on him pop. It's just certain things you don't do, and that's not one of them. These guys, I couldn't show you the whole thing because it's like a 5-hour thing. These guys were spitting in these cops' face. They do rocks at these guys. They do bricks. They do fireballs. They do piss bottles. You know how stupid, you know how fucking fucked up in the head you have to be to literally piss in a bottle and throw it at cops. Like this size cold drink bottle full of piss. They cut the top part off and was throwing it at them. You know how fucked up you have to be to do that? Like, really, dude? Like, you have to be a fucked up individual. So yeah, and she said that it would really be unacceptable if that shit happened to one of my blood, and it really don't have to be my blood. Anybody who serve us, who doing their job the right way, it shouldn't be that way. All right, shout out to you. Let's go to, cause I like your name, Patman C. Patman C writes in from Instagram, says thank you from putting a video out tonight. Today, we really appreciate you giving us your input on what's going on in Ferguson. I wanted to say I've been in Ferguson since the Michael Brown incident, and I was out there marching for Michael Brown, and I am a white guy, and when I went out there, people looked at me like I was wrong for marching for Michael Brown, but they get mad when we don't say Black Lives Matter. I am confused. And I don't even know what I should do anymore. Okay. I'm gonna answer that before I, let's go to Brittany call texting from Texas and texting on Instagram. Like your show, like your, what the topics that you're talking about. What happened to the sinks tonight? Ha 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 ha. Ha 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 ha. Yeah, I just wanted to weigh in on the Michael Brown situation. He had a bad mother and a bad father figure, so that's why Michael Brown ended up where he is at. I have a brother that's doing life in your state jail in Angola. In Angola, because he went down to New Orleans one summer and had a fight with a cop son and got into it and killed cop son. And now he's doing life in Angola. He's not even from Louisiana, but he's also doing time in your Louisiana state prison penitentiary. I think that's really fucked up. I really don't like cops just because a cop's son said he did this and did that, and then my brother went to fight him for slandering his name, and my brother wound up killing a guy by mistake and wound up getting life. So I don't agree what these people are doing, but I get what they are doing because the same mentality that they had between these cops just now, I had 2 years ago. Okay, I get that. At the same time, you're right. At the same time, you're wrong. Let's go to... I don't like to joke about the things. It's always going to be who that. You already know. Let's go to... Tommy is texting from Atlanta, and he's texting on Facebook, and he wanted to say, like the topic, don't like the song. I am an officer of the law in Atlanta, and I feel like these cops need more respect. They are doing bad things to these cops, but they want these cops to respect them and do what they say. And they want these cops to be good cops towards them. Only thing is they're gonna do is piss these cops off even more to do more bad things if they feel like they should. And it won't change us until people stop with the code of silence code and learn to trust us. Because they also have good and bad cops in every unit. You just have to be the person who's doing the right thing. I've been in law enforcement since I was the age of 18. I am now 45, and I've never had an incident with nobody saying I did anything disrespectful or went out of the line or anything. And I am a white officer. Got John, and you can go follow him. He said at his page, and his page is Atlanta's Proud Force at 1616. You can go follow him on Twitter account. So you can follow him on Twitter. I'm gonna go ahead and just hit it off because I only got like 3 minutes left. This is how I feel about the story. I feel like Ferguson's really fucking up, and they want everybody to fault. They want to fault all these people, but fault yourself. You had 6-month-year-old children, 6-year-old, 5-year-olds out here at a protest at 6 o'clock. 12 o'clock at night. The protest ended around like 5 o'clock in the morning. So you had all these people out here, all these children that should be at home, waiting for school for the next day, sleeping, going for school the next day. But you had all these kids out here throwing bricks, throwing piss bottles, bomb bottles, throwing all kind of shit at these cops because Michael Brown died. I can't think of her name, the girl that died in the jail in Texas. Trayvon Martin. All these people are looking down on you and saying, like, fuck, man. You don't think Michael Brown is saying, like, fuck, city? Come on, man. Chill out. Chill out, man. It's not gonna bring me back. But they are doing this shit. You don't think Martin Luther King is pissed off? You don't think Malcolm X, all these favorite people that looked up and did things for us to have freedom, Emmett Till, you don't think all these people are fucking pissed off about how we doing each other as black folks? We need to stop this shit, learn how to love each other. Until that day happens, it will never be a good city. It will never be a good place to be around niggas versus blacks. And niggas versus blacks are the baddest fucking thing, because niggas is being, blacks are being perpetrated as niggas, and we are not that. And so we change our mentality and change your heart, it will never be any peace. Hands up, Black Lives Matter don't mean shit, because black lives does not matter to black folks. It only matters when the person is motherfucking white. If he's black, it does not matter. Let's stop doing that, acting like Black Lives Matter. Because black lives being taken by black lives every fucking day. And nobody marches, and nobody says anything about it. I am a proud black man. But I am a smart fucking black man. Change yourself. Get God in your life. Till next time, this was Talk to Me Thursday. I will be back tomorrow for my analysis on the Saints preseason.